Ay, teka, saan po ang inyong EP? EP niyo po? Capiz? Cebu. So, ganito po ang marireceive niyo po. Pag clinic niyo po ang Cebu, you will see the frequency in Excel file. Ito po yung Talibon Father. Okay? So, pakita ko sa inyo ha. Okay, good. Yan. Magpaano siya messy. Pero I might as well just show you. Okay? Nung time na itong Father, hindi pa namin na ilalagay lahat. You only have 70 as of how yung encoded, right? Pero you have more than that, right? But anyways, just to show you that you will have all the names, their ages, okay? Okay, yan siya. Nakita niyo yung pinapakita namin kanina sa inyo? Okay, you have to know that we are giving you the frequencies, initial frequencies, raw frequencies, kasi nililinis pa po yan. But at least you see that we are processing your data. Gets? What is more important is the data for the ecclesiastical province. We also run the data for the ecclesiastical province of Cebu. Okay? Which would include the following. Yan. Cebu, Dumaguete, Maasin, Tagbilaran, Talibon. And at least for this ecclesiastical province, we have about 1,350 respondents. So each folder will have an ecclesiastical province, so you could see saan sila nag-iiba-iba. Kuha niyo po ba? So yun siya, may comparative ano na siya, interest, right? Now, these are raw. So, and there are more to come. But you want to see it, so we're giving it to you. Okay? We generated it in the last few days so that you could see it. Okay? And expect more. Okay? Now, what is more important is that I hope you will get to understand, given your background, how to read basic frequency table, right? Yun lang naman po ang kailangan natin dito. Okay? So, lahat po yan ay na-prepare na po namin for all of you. So, yan. So, also, if you are interested in understanding what is the state of catechetical ministry in the country, we already share, we are sharing this one. This is draft. This is a report prepared by one of our colleagues for you, but you do not have to quote, baka ma-misquote tayo. If you have questions, just email me. Okay? Pero ito po yung results na shinare namin sa inyo with explanations. Masaya na kayo. Okay, lahat to babahagi ko sa inyo para naintindihan nyo kung ano yung in-explain namin sa inyo. Dahil sa marami siyang frequencies and data, ang maganda dito is that when you have the entire file, pwedeng tingnan mo, ano kayo nangyayari sa Rizal? Ano nangyayari sa ano? Alam mo yun? So if you're interested, okay yun, di ba? Meaning, baka makagawa pa kayo ng analysis nyo. Are we all good?
Yes.
Hindi po kayo naantok kasi papaano na tayo, papa-workshop na tayo, right? So, I'm happy that everyone seems like interested, and I really hope that because we shared the literatures, we shared the initial data, we shared the modules, that you have enough tools for you to have some kind of a research framing when doing pastoral work. Okay? Kasi yun lang po ang ano namin, ang aming hope, that you will have a research perspective when deciding on things. So, enough of me. We still have 1 hour to go, probably. Ito na po tayo. Any questions? Questions? Excited na po kayo sa gagawin niyo? Okay? The vision is for me to see EP all together to do some kind of planning, no? And how are we going to do it? We're going to do it sa pamamagitan po nito. Okay. So, I will be providing you a workshop, data workshop, pastoral purposes. Mamaya na, pagka meron na mga EP. Each EP will have some kind of, but it's the same, ano? I just would like to explain how you are going to do it. And I don't think you could finish it now because this is an ongoing thing to talk about. Mamaya, ang gusto ko lang po mangyari is that I'm going to give you 1 hour to talk. And then before we leave each other, 2 o'clock pa lang po naman eh. So mga 3:15 after the break, pwedeng isa o dalawa lang po mag-share lang po kung anong tingin nyo, kung ano nangyari sa inyo. Yun lang. And then we end it through a prayer by Sister Rhea. Okay lang po ba? Okay. Now, let me explain to you the logic of the template. Okay? As you could see, it's made of, my dear, I need an assistance here. Oh, okay. Kasi I will be very emphatic. The conceptual data matrix is designed to help you do some kind of pastoral work. Okay? So, there are themes that we talked about. Paulit-ulit. Sabi mo, naku, alam ko na yan. Kasi yun talagang goal. For you to learn that there is an importance for you to understand a particular phenomenon using a concept. You cannot do some kind of planning without a conceptual frame. Okay? So, we have themes already. Identify demographic landscape, catechetical ministry, formation, content and pedagogy, and catechist life. Okay? Task mo lang ng konti, may dear. So, first is this. Given your intelligence, right? And your memory because you did not sleep throughout the day, you have to identify what are the research results relative to this concepts. Dapat kung ano naintindihan mo, di ba? Ito yung naintindihan natin eh. Ano yung tungkol sa demographic landscape? Ano yung tungkol sa catechetical ministry? Right? I'm not talking about our arguments. I'm talking about your understanding of the NCS results. Clear? Do not fool yourselves. Kasi, nandiyan naman eh, sa presentation, huwag niyong gayahin. Ito ang pagkaintindi ko na resulta. Right? Then, you start to talk about ano pa yung mga kailangan natin information relative to this. Because it may be that we did not ask the right question. It may be that there are more things that you know than us. So you have to identify what are the data or information that you most need in order to fully understand the pastoral implications of this. What does it mean? All throughout the day, you witness a very different type of presentation of research, which is for pastoral purposes. We have been thinking about the data relative to pastoral purposes. That makes it very different. We don't do it for purposes of academic exercise to get a degree. So, parang awa nyo na, ganun ang gawin nyo. You have to think, anong pastoral implication ng lahat ng ito? Ng findings, ng mga data na kailangan nyo, at yung pwede nyo gawin. Meaning, bilang catechetical leader, anong dapat natin gawin? Pastoral implication yon. Okay? Before you think of a project or a program. Kasi, ang problema sa ating lahat at dito sa lipunang ito, may programa saka mag-research. May K-12, wala naman palang research. Pwede nyo po ba? Pwede po bang ibahin natin ang ating pastoral planning mode? Okay? Meron tayong conceptual frame. Tingnan natin kung ano yung na-generate ng insights. Identify natin ano pa yung alam mo at kailangan natin malaman. Identify natin kung anong implication nito, saka tayong magsabi, ito magiging project natin. Does it make sense? This is different, I tell you. Even in schools, they don't do this. They just ask someone to develop something, key results, whatever, and that's it. Ngayon, let's make a big difference. May data na eh. Kasi ang problema doon, walang data. Now that you have the data, please make use of it. So I encourage everyone with all emphasis, shut up your mind to whatever program you are thinking. Bago ka mag-isip ng project, punta ka muna. Baka hindi siya kailangan. Baka yung mga project mo na palagi kang nag-Christmas party, hindi kailangan. Diba? Bakit ka papapunta ng papunta dun sa parish na yun? Hindi naman pala kailangan. Baka may iba silang kailangan. Diba? I don't know. Only you would know. The difference is that there is a basis for such respect to research before planning. Okay? Yes, ma'am. Yes, 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 father. Natotohanan na. Nandito na si father.
As putting myself in their shoes, and maybe siguro kailangan ng isang example.
Okay.
So I'll just give one example. Nasa na parte ng ano, yung data na children are the main, nasa, anong parte siya sa concept?
Saan po siya? Sa catechetical ministry.
Catechetical ministry, okay? Remember that data, the very clear, most of our catechists are catechizing children, youth, and very little, very few adults. Okay? So that is the result. What do I need for more information? Bakit? Bakit bata lang? Ba't hindi matanda? Why not the youth? So those are the information we can need. We need to know with that data. Okay? Pastoral implication. Our catechetical ministry is very childish. I mean, I just use a word to make us react. But what is the reality is that we're focused to children. And remember, I told you yesterday, my professor's contemporary heresy in the church is catechesis is equated to children only. But, principle-wise, from the general director of catechesis, adult catechesis is the chief form of catechesis. If there is no adult catechesis in place, we are not achieving what catechesis in the church is all about. We are catechizing children in order that as they grow, they love to learn about Jesus and youth and adults. Why do we have the problem of parents do not bring them to the church? Because they lack the understanding of the Eucharist. So, lack of catechesis. Right? Now, my project then is to maybe, unang-una, mag-survey ka ng situation ng adult catechesis or the situation of the faith situation of adults in your parish or in your diocese bago ka gumawa ng programa para sa kanila. So, yun yung parang to do today. Para lang kasi, otherwise, we'll be thinking of...
Thank you. That's very helpful, Father. Kanina, pag nag-uusap kami ni Father madalas, sabi ko, Father, pwede ko bang sabihin ito o hindi? Kasi kailangan kong humingi ng permission because sometimes, the radical social science me will demonize my academic being. But this is pastoral work, my dears. I make it a point that you really, we design it in a way that it will be very helpful to you. And thank you, Father, for giving a specific example. Huh? Very challenging. So, can we do it?
Yes.
Okay. You have 1 hour to do it. So you know your groups. And then each group will receive this one, okay? So you will have a sample lang to. Okay? So there you go. Let's do it.
Researcher tayo. Madali lang. Researcher tayo.
Lord. Okay. Sister Rhea, saan daw po pupunta yung bawat grupo? Okay. Kung saan part? Should I specify? where you want to go? Oh, you know na?
Yes.
Ah, you know na already. Father, they know na. You don't know. Not yet. Ako, na-stress ako dito. Kasi I don't catechize, right? So, okay. Si Father po. Ah, saan yung kasera? Siguro sasabihin ko na lang kung ano-ano yung mga ano po. Diocese. So, all will be good. Okay. So please identify yourselves. Per EP, per ecclesiastical faculty. Ay, faculty. Sorry. Ecclesiastical. Sorry. Province. Okay, let's do this. So we have Caceres. Where Caceres? Good. There you go. Cagayan de Oro. Only one. Sama na lang po kayo sa kanila. Pwede naman po pala. Okay. Capiz? Wala. Cebu? Yan. Ayan. So, magkita-kita na po kayo. Opo. Cotabato? Cotabato? Wala tayong Cotabato. Davao? Okay. Sama-sama na po kayo. Haro? Okay. Lingayen Dagupan, Father Chuck, Father Peter, ayan, magsama-sama po kayo. Lipa, nag-iisa lang ba, Lipa? Okay, magkakasama na, good. Manila, ito marami, saan kayo? Manila, where will you be? Probably somewhere here? Somewhere here, Manila. And then if you want to divide yourselves, it's okay, ha? It's okay. Then we have Nueva Segovia. Okay, magkakasama na sila. Osamis? Wala. Palo? Okay, sama-sama na po kayo. San Fernando? Okay, San Fernando, good. Tugigaraw? Okay. Arthur, kindly get share that.
Manila.
Sambuanga, wala. Military, ordinary, no? Huh? Opo, bahala na po kayo sumama ko kanina po. Pwede na po kayo, mag-planning. Pwede na mag-planning. Thank you. Ah, si Anna.
Yes. Yes.
Paano?